Welcome back to Belly Up Podcast, Charles.
Miles.
We're presented by Flea Farm.
Yes, we are.
How you feeling?
I'm doing good, man.
We're here in Castleton, North Dakota again at the Red Baron Lounge. What's going on?
Not much. I just got a text on my phone from my brother, and he was up at my Grandma Sue's. Yep. And he was showing me the picture was just of a paintbrush hanging from the rafters. Yep. And the paintbrush, you know, is hung there so you know how far to pull the car in. Yep. I just think that's one of the unsung, Midwest inventions that I feel like, you know, I want to know if any of the listeners out there have these kinds of things. I want them to send them in, because whether it's hanging a paintbrush, which is new, that was the first time I saw a paintbrush hung there. Usually it's a tennis ball.
Tennis ball. Yeah. I've seen a water bottle before.
Water bottle.
I got a cousin who did a Busch Light can.
Oh, nice.
Very on brand.
Nice.
My dad growing up, once in a while I got to used to park in the garage with my old truck. You know,
oh, he let you park in the garage
once in a while. And so what would end up happening is he actually took like a 2x2 block and just drilled it into the concrete. And so whenever my tire would go up against that, I knew when to stop.
Oh,
so
that's
a little different version.
Your dad must be in construction.
Oh, he knows his way around a drill.
Because to drill into concrete, that's not just your average drill.
He's a concrete guy.
He's a concrete. Yeah. That made sense. But yeah, are there other kind of inventions like that? You know, I also think another thing, if not an invention, is people in the Midwest really know how to open a bottle with anything other than a bottle opener.
Yeah. I mean, I think that it's to the point now where people don't even have bottle openers anymore because they're like, it's just a waste of space.
Right. Because if you're not drinking Red Stripe or Corona, you know, there's not really a need to have a bottle opener to begin with.
That's a funny bit, actually. God, I don't even have a bottle opener anymore. Like, oh, that's cool. Like, you just use like your ring or like just do it on a table. I'm like, no, all mine are twist off.
Yeah, what other beer? It's like craft beers or Corona or Red Stripe. Those are the ones with pop tops. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, you know? And I don't drink any of those.
No, you don't. But what's your favorite way to open up a beer bottle that isn't a beer opener?
I like to stick it in my belly button.
Can you do that?
And just twist her off that way.
Yeah. Oh, that twist off in the belly button? I could probably do that.
Yeah.
To pop it. You can use a lighter. You can use... your seatbelt, actually. If you have a seatbelt, you can use that.
I don't know why you'd be in the car doing that, Charlie.
No, well, this is why, is that I've got an old seatbelt in my garage hanging on the...
Of course you do.
it's hanging
it's
on the...
It's dangling from the ceiling, so you know how far to park up, is what you're saying?
Yeah. Also, the interior of a door. You know, like if you open a door and the little thing where the...
Yeah, I usually do mine on the dash of the car as well, Charlie, as well.
Oh, Miles, no. We do have to clarify there's no opening bottles
you
in
just
your cars.
Up car ones.
Well, there's a seatbelt. Now I'm forgetting that not everybody else has a seatbelt hanging in their garage as I do. So, anyways, those were just
thoughts. You forget that? Forget that a lot?
No, but it's just like when I say seatbelt, my immediate association is not inside a car because mine is hanging on my garage wall.
Gotcha.
So, but I'm just finding unusual places to open up a bottle with. And that's what I came up with. So anyways, we're here.
Our question about the bottle caps, though, regardless if it's twist off or not.
Yeah.
I am someone that likes to bend the caps in half. Where are you a bend in half type of
no,
guy?
No, that breaks my heart because I like to flick them.
Oh, like a little like frisbee disc type of move.
Yeah.
Like a bottle rocket.
Yeah, a little bottle rocket, exactly.
That actually did sound a lot like a bottle rocket.
That sounded really good.
Yeah.
I didn't know you were so good at sound effects.
It's a far away, distant bottle rocket exploding.
Miles, I want to go fishing at your. I want to go fishing at your lake house again.
Okay.
Remember when we did that?
Yeah.
And I caught all those fish, and you were getting mad because you weren't catching any.
I don't remember that.
You don't remember that part? No, I remember that part. I was bringing them in.
I was blacked out, I think.
You were drinking a bit.
No.
Just a bit. Me? Yeah.
No. No, it was, I let you have the good side of the boat.
Oh, was that it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, I told you to fish on my side of the boat.
So maybe next time, why don't you get your own lake?
Dang. Burn. Burn. I don't have a lake house. I don't.
You got to get one.
I know.
No, we'll have you out to the cabin this summer, Charlie. If you come. I don't know. It's sometimes, you know.
You have invited me a couple places, and I said I was going to go, and then I didn't come recently, and I do feel bad about that.
I'm surprised you're even making it to the wedding.
Oh, please. Of course I'm making it to the wedding. I feel bad.
Jared, do you want to know how far in advance I had to put my wedding on Charlie's schedule? The instant my knee came off of the ground proposing to Ann, I had to call Charlie and be like, you need to have this available. Then you got to call his manager. Then you got to call his mom. Then you call Grandma Sue. Then you can get on Charlie Baron's schedule.
Send him like 5 save the dates.
Yeah. He's like, God, it seems like they're really sending out a lot of these. Is that new? Is that a new thing?
You know what's funny? In like July of last year, my manager had a thing. He's like, hey, what's going on March 18th? I see it's blocked off on your calendar, and we've got an offer to do a gig. And I was like, I have no idea. Yeah. I literally said that. And I was like, just don't book it. Just put it on hold for now. It took me a month to remember. Boom.
Why don't when you block something off, instead of just blocking it off, why don't you write what the block is for?
Yeah, now I'm going to do that. That's a great idea, Miles. Where were you when I put that in my calendar to begin with?
I was standing right next to you. Because I wasn't letting you out of my sight until you put that in the calendar.
Yeah, I'm glad you
made it here today, though.
Thanks, Miles. Yeah, thanks for inviting me.
So the folks at home should feel good because you always show up when the folks are listening.
I show up for the folks. Yeah. And this is a beautiful establishment wherein we're in the Red Baron Lounge in Castleton. Ton of castles in this town.
There's a ton of them. Yeah.
Ton of castles. And we're just in.
You know, they actually got a hotel with a water slide.
Do they?
It's called the Governor's Inn.
No kidding.
I don't want to say it, but it's kind of a big deal. This town's had a lot of governors grow up here, so that's why it's the Governor's Inn.
Really? Which governors?
The Sinners.
The Sinners.
Yeah.
That's a cool name for a governor.
It is.
Governor Sinner.
Yeah.
Governor Sinner.
You can't quote me 100% on these facts, but I'm pretty sure Jared's confirming. Yeah.
Really? Like, you're not even yanking my tail?
No. I would never about something so serious that of governor talk.
You're not pulling my chain?
No. So, yeah. Big water slide here in town.
Have you gone down it?
I've looked at it.
Why are you afraid of water slides?
No, I just am worried I'll get stuck. You know, I'm to that age and size that I have to think about things like that. I know you just slipped down there like a hot dog down a hallway, but just every sound effect just sounds like a bottle rocket for me.
Miles, you're looking really trim these days.
You don't need to keep talking about that. It's you really are. Yeah, be cool. Let's be cool about it.
I mean, if I am feeling a certain way, I'm going to say it just so it's not on my brain anymore.
Am I making you feel a certain way?
No, you're looking good. You're looking really good. I just want to let you know that.
Oh, sorry. You are too, Charlie.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate that.
All right. Well, what do you think? Should we get some callers going? Or?
I think it's about that time, Miles. It's about that time.
Welcome to the Bellied Up Podcast. Who do we got on the line?
Oh, you got Jeremy Rodriguez.
Jeremy Rodriguez.
Come on down.
What's cooking, Jeremy? Belly on up to the bar and tell us what's on your mind.
Well, you know, I've been listening to this podcast for a while now, and all I hear is like a lot of ranch talk, and I wanted to get my feelings out about this hot topic of ranch, right?
Oh,
wow.
Please.
I personally feel that ranch doesn't belong on everything.
Oh,
okay.
Okay. Hot take.
I didn't know that we woke up this morning and chose violence, but here we are.
Here we are, Mr. Rodriguez. Okay.
Well, go ahead. Why don't you state your case on why ranch doesn't belong on everything.
You know, I think that, you know, it can go on a good salad, but like on pizza, I think it's just too much. Mm. And I don't like my curds with any ranch. I just like, you know, the squeak.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, the problem is,
you know what? We can let the squeak pass.
Okay. We can.
That one we agree with.
All right. The pizza thing, I want to back up the train here. And you said you think, and I think that's the problem here. You need to feel in your soul. And once you're feeling, coming from a place of feeling and not thinking, you are going to become one with the ranch.
You know, Charlie, I should have rephrased. I have a strong feeling towards the ranch on the pizza.
He does feel. Yeah. Okay.
All right.
All right. We established that. All right. All right, man. If you think ranch isn't all it's cracked up to be, what are you replacing ranch with?
I honestly don't think anything else needs to be on a pizza. I think a mean pizza is all you really need. Like, you know, you don't really need a side sauce or anything like that. You know, I think it just pizza by itself is perfect. But in other circumstances, I don't know. I'm not really like,
what do you dip your wings in? What do you dip your wings in?
Buffalo sauce.
Aren't they already caked in buffalo sauce?
Well, you can get buffalo sauce on the side, Miles. And that's actually a big thing in the wings community. And I know we've upset some people, Mr. Rodriguez. I think we've upset you as well. With wings, a lot of times people would prefer blue cheese as opposed to ranch.
Yeah, what do you think of blue cheese?
I don't want that stuff anywhere near my wings.
Okay. Oh.
All right, so
at least we found common ground. So he's just a ranch hater.
Jeremy, it's Jeremy, correct?
Yeah, it is.
So, Jeremy, you're maybe not, your hatred is maybe not necessarily need to be geared toward just ranch. It's all sauces. You're just not a sauce guy.
I think a lot of my friends and a lot of folks would say that. And, like, I mean, you're not completely wrong. I don't like a lot of sauces mingling with my food. Like if it's spaghetti, you got the sauce on there. It's supposed to be like that.
Okay.
But we don't need an extra side, you know. You got to have what's already on there.
So Mr. Rodriguez doesn't like getting lost in the sauces from what I understand.
I see what you did there, Miles.
What? Okay. You absolutely despise sauces, but you do got to pick one sauce. That is the king of sauces. What is it?
The king of sauces. Oof. I put what's that stuff called? I put man, I can't believe what is it? Hold on, give me one second. I'm running to my fridge to find out what it is.
Yeah, go to your fridge, find out what it is.
Not good. This is not good for this said sauce.
I put that all right.
Can't even remember what it's called.
Chick-fil-A sauce are a lot of my sauce on my products, like a mean chicken sandwich at home with some Chick-fil-A sauce. I'd say that goes pretty well.
Well, Jeremy, I'm going to remind you that Chick-fil-A does not just have one sauce. It has many sauces.
Right? The original.
The original. Okay.
So what usually happens when you get ranch or something unexpectedly comes with ranch that you don't want, will you just send it back?
Oh no, I'm not that type of person. I'll eat it. It's not the worst thing. If I personally had an opinion on it, I wouldn't, you know, touch it. I wouldn't go buy it. You guys are probably gonna make fun of me for this, but I don't like any sauces on my salads. And that's a pretty hot topic for a lot of people.
You're eating that salad dry?
That is, you are eating salad dry.
Jeremy, how much salad are you eating, friend? We got to figure out if you have serial killer tendencies now.
You call a salad the leaf that comes on your Chick-fil-A sandwich or what? That's not a salad. That's a leaf.
It's actually a pickle.
No. I like the occasional salad, you know. Hold on.
That was a very dry coffee hat. I wonder if you could maybe wet your whistle a little with a little bit of ranch. Whatever you're eating didn't go down too easy.
And also, did you know, Jeremy?
Did you know, Jeremy
Rodriguez, that ranch has antioxidants in it, and it actually is packed full of vitamin C. And perhaps that cough that you have is a direct response to you not having enough ranch in your diet. Did you ever think of that?
No, Charlie, are you telling me that my lack of ranch intake is causing the decline of my health?
That's exactly what I'm telling you, Jeremy Rodriguez.
I've never seen Charlie sick before, and that guy drinks ranch by the gallon.
I do. I chug ranch, and that's why I'm a healthy person.
I've seen him do it.
No. I just went to the doctor's today, and turns out I have pneumonia, so that's what the giant cough is.
Okay, now, and did the doctor tell you? Did he tell you you're not having enough ranch?
Have you never heard the phrase, every single day you drink ranch so that you can keep the doctor away?
Miles, it's a ranch bottle a day keeps the doctor away.
I'm so riled up.
Yeah, he's getting so steamed, he's misconstruing his phrasing. Ideologies. Clearly, they didn't teach you all the things you needed to learn there. So we're here to set the record straight. If you want a life of health, and I think you do, I think this pneumonia is here to teach you a lesson. You make sure to put ranch on everything you eat, including, you know, and in especially a salad. I mean, eating vegetables raw over here.
Let's go back to that.
Next thing he's going to tell me is he's not deep frying his pickles.
So basically what you're saying is for dinner, for dinner, you would just be okay with just walking up to a tree and just raw dogging leaves right off of the tree. Because that's basically what you're doing with a plain salad in the first place. Is that what you're telling
us? Miles. The funny thing is, my parents were vegan for about 5 years, and I grew up in that. So, might as well if I'm already eating all this shit.
I figured it out.
Yeah, he's got vegan parents.
He was raised on veganism.
Yeah, he was raised by deer. Yeah. You know?
Oh.
But speaking if a deer ever got the taste of ranch, I would definitely do it.
Yeah, you put ranch in a... In the woods. They'll be back there, I'll tell you that. What'd you say, Jeremy?
Despite living in Wisconsin for almost my entire life, I've never had venison.
Oh, Jeremy,
I mean, this is what veganism's all about. This is what's depriving the youths of delicious meats and delicious sauces.
Depriving is exactly right.
Well, Jeremy, you come on over to my garage, okay? I got a freezer full of it, all right? I'll give you a nice cut, send you on your way.
What are you doing the next round of jerky, Charlie?
Oh, that's a good question. Well, I'd probably come the spring, get out there in the garage, dehydrate it out there.
So does it become sweater weather again?
Yeah.
Get that smoker going.
Yeah, that's a good call right there. We'll get you some jerky. How does that sound? Do you eat meat now or no?
Sounds amazing. Oh, yeah. I'm a big meat eater.
Mm. Well,
that's what happens when, you live for 5 years of your life and without any meat, you just go back.
Yeah. It's like strict parents. Those kids always end up being the troublemakers.
That's true.
The vegan kids always end up being the ones sucking down red meat,
Yeah. Well, listen, Jeremy, we feel for you. Okay. This is not your doing. It's your parents doing. Let them know. We'd like them to call the podcast. We'd like to have a chit chat with them. Okay. We don't want to have to call protective services on them, but we're going to have a little chit chat. Okay?
That is damn near a child protective services call from depriving your child of ranch.
Yeah. He's eating dry lettuce and listen to that cough.
Yeah.
Gosh.
Can you imagine just eating just a head of lettuce plain?
No.
I get that complaint all the time. I get it all the time. People will see me out in public and they'll be like, "What the hell are you doing?"
Yeah. That's what we're wondering, and we're not even seeing you. We're just hearing you. Oh, man. Well, Jeremy, I think we've set you straight, okay? Be adventurous with your ranch intake. And come on over to the garage and we'll hook you up with some venison.
And the final thing too.
Oh yeah,
is,
I'll put it in my smoker.
Yeah. The final thing I'll leave you with is, if you don't really like ranch that much, he's probably just never had a good ranch.
That's true. Yeah.
I got the Hidden Valley in the fridge. I just don't
need
it that much.
That's your problem. Oh my God.
I mean, I don't have a problem with Hidden Valley myself, but I know Miles is vehemently opposed to it.
Here we go. You gotta get yourself a good low viscosity ranch. You gotta. I mean, this is what's wrong with America. They're all eating Hidden Valley, and they're not having any good. All the youths, none of them are eating the good ranch. They got all that Hidden Valley shit. Yeah. So try a good ranch once, then maybe we can talk.
Yeah, I'll update you.
All right,
Jeremy. Hey, you be safe out there and you watch out. Right. Watch out for trees. Don't eat them. Okay.
Yeah.
Don't eat them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Real good.
All right. Bye.
See ya.
I'm going to be honest, Charlie.
Yeah.
I can't think about anything other than watching this guy raw dog a salad.
I don't. When was the last time you raw dogged a salad?
Like you've heard of. You think I raw dogged a salad ever, Charlie?
I mean.
Lettuce is just the utensil to get the ranch in your mouth, mm-hmm. you know? I mean, you've heard of like the that's a serial killer trait. I didn't want to say it to his face because if he is a serial killer.
I think I did say that.
You did?
I think so. Did I call him a serial killer?
Don't call a serial killer a serial killer.
Oh, that's true.
Wouldn't that be something? If a serial killer's serial killer like tendency thing was every time someone called him a serial killer because he did something weird, he would kill them. That'd be a whole
meta thing. That's a whole Netflix show right there.
I think we just...
We pitched the show. We've so many great ideas come out of this podcast.
I don't know.
I mean, ideas anyway.
I can't wait to hear our next big idea on the next caller.
Me either. Welcome to the Bellied Up Podcast. Who do we have the pleasure of speaking with today?
This is Lori from Fond du Lac.
Lori from Fond du Lac. How are you?
Fondy.
Good. How are you?
Fondy. I love it. Where in Fond du Lac do you live?
Near Ace Hardware.
Oh, nice. Nice. I was just over
no,
there recently.
No, you know. I saw you there, remember?
Oh, this is that, Lori.
Yeah. I just thought I'd give you guys a call. I saw it come across on my phone that you guys were open for business.
Oh, yeah. We are open for business, Lori. Thanks for calling. What's on your mind today? Belly up to the bar with us and tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I couldn't think of a question, but I said how to find a boyfriend after 50.
Okay.
Should I be going to Ace Hardware?
That's a good start. Yeah. It's a great hardware store. Listen.
Okay, all right. So let's set the stage then. So you said that you're over 50 years old, correct?
Yes.
And you're single, ready to mingle is what it sounds like.
Yeah, I had a boyfriend for quite a while, but that stopped. So I'm kind of afraid to date again.
Okay. Well, let's
maybe talk through that a little bit. Let's get her unafraid.
What made you?
What's holding you back getting back out there?
I think I'm kind of shy and... I always want my son's approval, and I don't always find somebody that I think they'll like too. Even though they're like 30. That is really sad.
No.
I just talked to my grandson, and I picked him up from school, and he said to me in the car, Gami, if you get married again, is that going to be daddy's new dad? He won't have... his old dad anymore, and I was so sad.
Oh,
it was just sad.
Yeah, that is sad. But
he's just curious. I think that sad about it. I think
I know. It's just he asks me every time I pick him up from school. He asks me questions about that. About if
every
I still
time,
what are,
I,
what are his parents and... talking about at home?
Yeah,
I mean,
I am serious. He asked me all the time,
shouldn't that be kid be worried about reading Captain Underpants books or what?
I think so. Yes, you're right.
Okay, yeah. Well,
maybe I'll bring him some toys tonight.
Hey, quit asking me about my love life and play with these toys.
Now, listen.
So where's that bar you guys are at? I'm just curious.
We're over at the
Minnesota
Red Baron Lounge in Fargo.
Castleton,
North Dakota, just outside of Fargo. But, you know, we got to get down to Fond du Lac. North Dakota. We got to get down to Fond du Lac and do some stuff at some bars down there at some point.
I think so.
Yeah.
I think you'd get a really good turnout.
Yeah. Now, listen. So you're looking for a gentleman over 50, okay? So let's start.
Well, he doesn't have to be. He can be younger than that.
Oh, okay.
I don't want any. Hey, I don't want any old guy that has a cane.
No canes. No pain,
well,
no cane.
Unless he just broke his leg.
What's no permanent canes. Yeah. Okay.
Let's talk.
It can only be temporary.
All right. Let's talk non-negotiables. What's the red flag to you if you see it when you're running the other way? Canes are number one. What else?
Tattoos.
No all
canes,
right.
No tattoos. What else?
No. Weird shoes.
Okay.
No weird shoes.
And what do you consider?
Hang on. What? Yeah. Go on ahead.
What
Miles.
Do you consider a weird shoe?
Like those clog type things. You know, they're called the ones with the little holes. Why can't I think of it?
Crocs.
Yes. No
Crocs.
Well, now we maybe have to lower your standards.
Yeah.
Well, unless he's a doctor. Unless he's a doctor.
So, I ain't saying she a gold digger.
No.
He can literally look like a sack of potatoes as long as he's rich, and that's I'm all for it.
Yeah, if he's a doctor and he has tattoos all over, I don't care.
I suppose you want a good retirement plan, right?
No, I'm fine on my own.
Okay.
I take care of myself.
Okay, so you're doing fine. So, all right, those are your non-negotiables.
But
no canes, no tats, no Crocs.
Unless...
No cats. No cats.
Oh, you've got more. No canes, no Crocs, no cats, no tats. What else? Do we have more? No.
What else? Keep going. Fire them out.
No mustache.
No mustache.
What about a beard?
A scruffy beard.
Oh, okay. A scruffy beard.
And the mustache can be scruffy too, but nothing like really super long.
She's literally just looking for. Do you like the show Grey's Anatomy? Sounds like you're looking for McDreamy, is what it sounds like.
Oh, I've never seen that show.
Oh, well
you would love
work.
It. Yeah.
Okay, so we've got the stuff that you don't like. What are you looking for in a gentleman?
That's what I'm looking for, a gentleman. Somebody that takes me out to dinner and opens the door for me and holds my hand. And when we walk, he walks on the side where the cars go by.
Okay.
See, okay, I want to touch on that
one. So you don't get splashed.
So you don't get splashed or hit by one of those cars.
You're speaking like a true Fond du Lac woman.
Yeah.
Is that it? Oh,
no.
Is that a bad thing?
No. This is a great thing. You know, I think
if you're in Texas, though, you're not as worried about all the during springtime. You're not worried about the water splashing, you know?
Yeah.
That's kind of what I was getting at. Go ahead, Charlie.
Not as much water. Oh. I think that walking on the side of the road that the cars are on, I think that that's something a lot of fellas have forgotten, I think.
Miles? I think so. Yep.
See, I always try and do that so that. If a car comes barreling, I'll take the brunt of it, you know?
Yeah. No, that's
sweet.
That is sweet.
I mean, if you think, though, that she's safe from getting hit by that car and I'm going to stop it like I'm the Hulk, that's just not true. It's just...
It's an emotional thing.
Yeah, it's an emotional thing. She's still screwed.
Yeah, that's okay as long as...
It's the thought that
we
counts.
Both get killed together. Yeah.
Sounds like a Nicholas Sparks book.
and instead of the rain coming down, it's just a big puddle from the car.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
you guys
exactly.
are both soaked because like a truck came by. Hit,
what do you want? She's like, I want you to be able to lift this car off of me.
So what activity, how have you been?
Yeah, what do you like to do? Let's get a, if you're saying where do you look, let's start with what you like to do.
Like a couple times a month I go out to eat with my friend.
Okay.
I know I do not do a lot of activities.
What do you do at home? Are you just watching shows or?
I'm kind of busy right now with my family, but yeah, I guess I watch football and basketball.
Wow.
I go to my parents, watch the games. I usually like watch the Bucks at night by myself, unless it's my weekend. I go to my mom and dad's.
Got
and
it.
I like baseball. I watch the Brewers and
you're a sports
Marquette
gal.
And UW.
You're a sports gal. That's great. That's, I mean, you're already halfway there.
You are. Now, do you go to the games? Do you actually go to the games or do you go to a bar ever to watch the games?
I don't want to go by myself to the bars.
You need a wing woman or a wingman. You know what?
So what's your son doing? He should be wingmaning you.
He's got his own family.
Bring the family along, too. You got a whole wing family
to the bar.
You know what? I'm going to tell you this. Yeah, if you don't want to bring them with you to the bar, my Grandma Sue and my Aunt Mary are both single gals. Hanging out in Fond du Lac, you know, maybe you go knock over on their door and ask them if they want to go go have one over at Schmitty's, you know.
Okay, Schmitty's is nice.
Yeah, Schmitty's. They got great stuff over there. And that's a nice, expansive place. And then maybe you seek out the fella that kind of fits your you know, categories. You know, fits into the things you like there. Looks like he might hold your hand and that hand is not tatted up. No Crocs on that fella. Have my Aunt Mary go over there and make the intro. She'll do it.
Oh, I've talked to her. She is not afraid to go do it. I can tell you that much. She will. I mean, she let Charlie have it on the lawn thing when she was on.
Yeah,
so.
She was all pissy at me. So I will tell you this. She is an outgoing personality, and you seem like more of a reserved personality. You need a friend that's an outgoing personality that can, you know, hook you up with a fella the old-fashioned way, which is meeting face-to-face at a bar, and go that route. You know, I think that's all you need.
And nomatch.com.
No match.
No.
Forget that. Those dating apps. Woof. No, thank you.
You're not looking for a hookup. You're looking for a gentleman.
Yeah.
You know?
Have you tried the dating apps?
Yes. It's very sad.
Okay. What's your worst dating app experience?
Do you really want me to tell you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You guys want to hear? It's kind of sad. It's, I don't know if it's appropriate.
Well, just say it.
Well, we can bleep it out if we have to.
Okay. The guy, I never met him in person yet. He called and we were talking every once in a while. He was a realtor. And one day he called me and he's talking. He said he was at one of his homes showing the house. And he kind of took a pause and he kind of sighed. And then I'm like, are you okay? He's like, oh, I just went to the bathroom. And that really grossed me out.
He was peeing while on the phone.
Number one or number two, do you think?
I did not ask.
If you had to guess.
One.
Okay. One. Yikes.
You know,
I guess I could have made it funny and said two, but I just thought that was so inappropriate.
Yeah. I mean, how was he even aiming if he was on the phone with you as one, my first thought?
Well, he probably sat.
Oh,
that's a red flag.
I'm sorry.
No.
Oh God, I'm getting sick just thinking of this.
Guys, yeah, me too, a little bit.
If you're a
sorry,
listen, we're gonna put out an SOS message for you here, Lori. If you're a single man in Fond du Lac that doesn't have tats,
that stands to pee,
that stands for something, especially to pee. That is not on the dating apps. No Crocs. Their shoes don't float. No cats. And someone who will walk on the right side of the road. Get in touch with Lori.
Yeah, that's it. We're not asking for that much.
We're not asking for a lot.
We're not.
No.
You don't think so?
No. And that fellow's
out. Oh, they have to have a job, too.
He's got to have a job.
He has to have a good job.
Ooh, okay.
What if he's retired already, though, at 55? Then
Oh, well, that's okay.
Okay.
And what's the age that's range? Okay. Give us the age range here. How young will you go? How old will you go?
I don't know. I would go pretty young because I think I'm kind of like a young person. So I don't know, like 40 or something.
Well, I was going to say like 25. You sound like you could hang with the 25.
Okay. Yeah, 25. Well, Charlie met me. Maybe he doesn't think 25.
Oh, no, I met you. I think you can go as young as Charlie. You want to go. No. Oh,
really? You don't think she could go as low as 25, Charlie?
You know what? We took a picture, didn't we?
Yeah, so I was really nervous about that.
Yeah, yeah. I do remember. Why don't you send that picture over to us and we'll make a dating profile for you on Belly Up.
I look like I'm having a nervous breakdown because I was so nervous when I took the picture.
Oh, it's fine. People look through it. Send that over. We'll put it on the Belly Up thing and we'll put your phone number right there.
Phone number, email, social security number.
The whole deal.
Home address.
And we'll put your likes and not likes on it. And then
we'll also release your tax returns as well so everyone can know that.
Uh-huh.
And then that should be a complete profile for you.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe you can edit it a little so I don't look so weird.
Well, she's not even worried about the personal information.
You send over whatever picture you want, and when this episode comes out.
No, it's good because I'm with you in the picture, so then they'll say, oh, it's Charlie.
Oh,
then
yeah.
Here's the thing.
Well, she knows Charlie.
If her age range is to 25, Charlie, I think that you're in her age range if I do the math.
Oh, jeez. Well,
we already got a photo together.
I unfortunately wear Crocs. So
that is true.
That's I've already been.
Charlie's could be my son.
Well, if you're going down to 25, I think that's the case with almost anyone.
I guess you're right. Yeah. No, good for you, Charlie, and the Crocs, but your dad's a doctor, so that's okay.
Yes.
Oh, hey, his dad is taken, okay?
Yeah, and keep in mind, I don't have any of that money. There are 12 people in my family, so when you divide, there's no inheritance
his
happening.
His dad's leaving him the taxidermy in the basement.
Yeah, there's no money in that banana stand, I'll tell you that much.
Oh,
right,
and I was never even thinking like that.
Well,
Miles, what'd you do to me?
I do tend to be an instigator. I do tend to corrupt.
How did the two of you guys meet?
On Match.com.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. You guys are a good match.
Yeah. No, we went into the bathroom.
I'm happy for you.
We went into the bathroom together, and he stood to pee. So I said, "This is my guy."
Yeah.
Just like you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, hey, if all that fails, just get some liquid courage in you. Go solo to the bar and just get up on the karaoke and just belt it out.
I will do that. That sounds good.
Yeah. What's your karaoke tune?
It has to be something. I have no idea. I've never done karaoke.
Don't stop believing. You practice it. You rock it out. You're going to find a fella. I guarantee you.
I actually feel like, you're over 50, but I think this is the first day of the rest of your life. I think you're about to have a little resurgence of young energy. You're going to do some stuff out of your comfort zone. You're going to go to a bar solo. You're going to have a couple drinks. You're going to flirt with the locals. And I think you're going to find yourself a guy. If I'm looking at the globe in front of me,
the fortune,
if I'm seeing your fortune out, I think that that's what's going to happen.
Crystal ball.
Your crystal ball.
We found it.
I almost said snow globe. If I'm looking at your crystal ball, I'm seeing you getting out of your comfort zone and really just living it up.
Okay. Thank you.
No.
I'm excited.
Lori. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, and I appreciate talking with you guys.
Appreciate talking to you.
You're fun.
Too.
You made my day.
Oh, you made ours. You made ours. Now go knock on my Aunt Mary's door, and you guys go over to Schmitty's.
Okay.
All right?
All righty. Have a good night, you guys.
You too now. We'll see you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
What a sweetheart.
What a sweetheart. That grandson of hers.
Grandkids really giving her heck.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I mean.
Barely able to talk and already, roasting her.
You're like 12.
Was it 12?
I don't know.
I was getting the impression super young, so whatever.
Grandma, why are you so lonely?
Kids.
Why do you go
brutal
in your bedroom and close the door for 10 minutes and cry?
Oh, she's so sweet. I met her outside the hardware store and
good gal.
Yeah, really is.
I really do hope she finds a new boyfriend.
She will.
She will.
We put that out there.
All right.
All right.
Tip it on back. Oh, tip it on back. Tip it on back. Oh, tip, tip, tip. Tip it on back. Back.
Folks, it's April 27th. It's my birthday. That's right.
Is it?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Charles.
Happy birthday, Charles.
So how old are you? 42?
I'm older. Miles, come on.
Doesn't matter how old you are, Charlie. It's what matters is that you got an ice cold glass of Tippy Cow to celebrate.
And today isn't just my birthday, it's the NFL draft. So we are going to draft our favorite Tippy Cow flavors.
Yeah, what round, what pick you taking Tippy Cow?
I'm taking the Shamrock one in the first round for sure. Tippy Cow in the first round, but Shamrock.
I got pick number 32 because I won the championship last year, so I'm gonna take I'm gonna take the vanilla one.
Always flexing.
First round 32. So,
so we are going to do a cap flip to determine who gets the first round pick to go from here. That's how we're
already determined the pick.
I guess
I got 32, so you got the first round pick because you guys stunk last year.
All right, fair enough.
Well, happy birthday, by the way.
Thanks, dude. What'd you get me?
Tippy Cow.
Appreciate that.
Let's tip it on back to your birthday.
Cheers.
And to Tippy Cow.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, if you got a DIY project going on, you got to go down to Fleet Farm. They're going to have everything that you need. They're going to have snacks. They're going to have tools. They're going to have materials. And then if you get bored of doing your DIY project and you want to hit the lake, you got to go there for all their fishing equipment. They got lures. They got rods. They got reels. They got it all.
5 gallon buckets too. Check them out. Fleet Farm. Welcome to the Bellied Up Podcast. Who we got on the horn here?
This is Josh.
Josh.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. You're here with me, Charlie, and my co-host here, Miles.
How we doing?
I'm doing good.
All right. So belly on up to the bar. Tell us what's on your mind.
So I've got a classic question here. Yeah. I was on the job site at a, let's just call it a gentleman's facility. I was running some cable through the ceiling, and I opened up a particular ceiling pile, and I found some money. And I'm not sure what I should do. Should I leave it? Should I take it? I left it for now.
I was going to say, where is it now?
Back. All right, Josh. Yeah. How much money are we talking?
It was a lot. I'm probably north of 500.
North of 500. You found this at a strip club?
Yeah.
Whoa. Gentlemen's club, Charlie.
Oh,
okay.
Sorry. Gentlemen's facility. Yes. I'm just trying to get the facts on the table. Is this gentleman's facility still in operation?
Yeah.
And what state is this?
I'm not going to say that.
Yeah, I think that that's...
What? You can't tell me the state?
I don't think we need to give any more information on what strip club this is. Or, sorry, gentleman's club that this is.
Yeah, that's
because,
right.
Because
what if he
you
takes
know,
the money?
Think of the people that do own gentlemen's clubs sometimes. I mean, you're a big Sopranos guy.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah. You don't want to.
That's someone going to see, you know, that's Charlie's golden retrieverness in him. It's always. Yeah. Thinking that everyone's going to be trustworthy and
Miles teaches me
stuff like that.
Miles teaches me how hard this world can be sometimes.
It's a doggy. It's a doggy dog world.
And I've never seen a golden retriever eat another one. And but Miles knows. So, all right. So you're doing exactly what job in the ceiling tiles that you found this cash money?
I'm doing a audio visual work, so I'm pulling cables essentially.
You're pulling cables, and was this stacked together with a rubber band around it, or
is it loose? Or
no, it was wrapped and bundled, but there's a lot of dust on there.
There's a lot. Someone clearly forgot about this $500.
That's kinda sick.
All right. Now,
okay.
Oh, wait.
First of all. something's not adding up here. There's got to be more than $500 up there if it's wrapped in a bundle and there's multiple bundles sitting there.
No, it was one bundle.
Yeah, one okay, bundle. Where'd you get multiple bundles from?
All right. How many more days do you got to work there? How many days of work left do you have on this job?
Probably less than three.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Now, where in the club is it? Are we talking in the above the locker room? Are we talking above the pole?
Yeah.
Are we talking above the bar? Where is it?
It was in between the bar and the stage.
In between okay. the bar so, I mean, and the stage.
That's a place for anybody just to... It took somebody with a ladder, you know?
Okay.
And there's dust on it. Now... Are you sure you didn't happen to leave $500 there?
Last time you worked on this place, did you happen to leave $500 in the ceiling? You just forgot about it?
No.
And this is still in operation.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm honestly not saying much because I am. This is a truly sticky situation.
Yeah. It is,
and
very...
not just because it takes place in a gentleman's club. It's
why would is... that be sticky? Oh, they spill soda on the floor.
Yeah, yeah.
Are
because,
you?
Because let's weigh the options, right?
Yeah.
You
okay.
can risk taking the money.
Yep.
Then he might get his ass beat with a guy with brass knuckles on.
That's
right?
true.
He might also lose his job because mm-hmm. the club then tells them then all that.
Yep.
Now, if he doesn't take it. And it truly is up for grabs. That is $500 he could spend at the bar. Wow. Okay.
Yeah, I
got
think
the
we both
got
it.
We got
yeah.
it. Yeah.
Put the
we
money back in rotation.
Yes, exactly.
You know?
Don't ever take it out of the gentleman's club. You're going to take it from the ceiling. You're going to bring it down. You're going to put it on the stage, and then you're going to leave.
Spread the wealth around. It's not fair for you to take all that money.
Correct.
But yes. there's a lot of hardworking people in that club that should be tipped.
You know what? I think that they earned it. You know?
I think so, too.
Or they will earn it once you flash it in front of them, you know?
Have you ever danced on a pole, Miles?
No.
I performed as a stripper on an MTV show back in the day.
No, you didn't.
As an extra. Yes, I did.
What?
It's called The Hard Times of RJ Berger. And in one of the episodes, there was a strip club scene, and I was an extra, and I was wearing a Scottish kilt.
And you were stripping?
I was pretending to be a stripper, but my point in saying all this is not to flex on you and let you know that I had a really thriving film career at one point
yep.
as a background actor on this MTV show nobody knows. But I was asked to dance on the pole, and that is a very hard
yeah.
thing to
oh,
do.
Yeah.
And so I think that we should
I mean, not that I would know that or have ever seen how hard it is. I would never, wouldn't know that, but if I had to guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
never seen it in action before is what I mean.
I think we understand what you're,
okay.
I'm picking up what you're putting down and believes you. And, so I think that's it. I think you either put it back to either tip it to the bartender after getting quite a few drinks or you, put it right on the stage.
I think it's not stealing. It's investing and you're investing in the local economy. You are stimulating the local economy. And I tell you what, I think that if you do that, if you take that money and you stimulate the local economy, I think you're going to have a happy ending on all this.
It's a stimulus package,
it
if
really
you will.
Is. You really give them the stimulus package.
We're not talking about the money at this point.
Are you picking up what I'm putting down, much like the strippers will do once you steal this money?
Yeah.
Oh, Miles.
Yeah, I'm picking it up.
You know, Miles with his play on words. He
I don't
always
think that was play on words. I think that was just straight out. I just said it.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I think we have your solution.
to take it.
Well, yeah.
To redistribute it.
Yeah. Stimulus package. Are we not being clear right now?
I think he's...
No, very, very clear.
Okay.
All right. Well,
unless he's like Mormon or something and he's not allowed to spend time in one of those.
Yeah. Do you have morals?
I've got pretty good morals. Yeah.
Well, he's calling into this podcast, so that makes sense.
That's questionable morals.
Yeah. So we gave you a questionable solution to this conundrum you're in.
Yeah.
You know what? Change all of it. I know what you do. Throw everything we've said away. There is a ceiling ventilation system. There is a an HVAC in that deal. Okay, you've got like some sort of hot or cold air blowing in through that sucker. What you do is you work the night shift, and when things are heating up in that club, drop that money down, and let it actually rain.
I love it.
Okay, he's definitely not doing that one.
That was such a forced laugh.
I know. He was appeasing me.
I know.
I didn't
love it either, Charlie.
Yeah, we can just cut that. cut that out of the thing. We'll
keep it in there.
Yeah. Okay, just so people know how bad my joke bombs.
Well, no, it didn't bomb. It just didn't hit.
Yeah. But you get where I was going with it.
You were literally making it rain.
Yeah.
Which he was already planning on doing, but he would be able to reap all the benefits of being the one making it rain.
Yeah, this lacks any benefits.
Yeah.
Now I
think we solved your problem. I don't even think we need to ask him if we did. We just did.
Yeah, thanks for calling in. We do appreciate you, and you'll do the right thing. You'll find it in your heart.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Thanks for calling in.
Yep.
Charlie, we are on the top of our game. We both came to the same conclusion at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Sparks flew, emotions ran high, tractor beams sucked us right in. And we were on the same page there.
Yeah, that was nice.
Is that what you would do? You would reinvest?
Honestly, I'd just take the money and run.
Would you?
Yeah.
You do run faster than me, I suppose. A little less weight to carry, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Not for long, though. I'm coming for you.
What if he takes it, spends it, and it's counterfeit?
That would be, it's just Monopoly money.
Yeah.
Also, though, that would suck, though, if it was like he actually got his ass beat for taking the money.
Yeah. Brass knuckles. I did. That became a real solution or a real thing that could happen.
Yeah, actually. So hopefully he listens to this and knows. If there's any threat of that, please do not take the money.
Yeah, it's a good PSA for our listeners.
Yeah.
Well, Miles, this was another fun episode of the Bellied Up podcast.
Is that it? Yep. That's it, baby.
Yeah, that's it.
Hey, wasn't it?
Another one in the books.
Literally, I was having so much fun, I didn't even know we were wrapping it up.
Time flies like a banana.
And that's actually how a lot of kids get born. Having way too much fun, you don't even know to wrap it up.
Yep, and bananas. All right, folks. Well, everybody, you stay safe out there as you're driving around in your automobiles. And if you find a big lump sum of money at a potentially mob run operation,
go straight to the gentleman's club.
Yeah, there you have it. There you have it. All right. Me and Miles, your fearless advice givers, are signing off for now, but we hope to see all of you soon, and give Lori a call in Fond du Lac. She's waiting for you.
Real good now. Love you guys. Tip your bartender.
Bye-bye.